Okay, so today's topic is on equity and bond. In fact, equity and bond is the most popular financial instrument, and I would say it's like 60-40. So equity is probably 60, sorry, equity is probably 40 and bond is probably 60. Okay, so now the reason for that is because bond has lower risk from this perspective of this investor. Okay, so of course, equity is a share. In short, bonds is a debt financing. You know, so it's just like you borrow money from the bank. And financial market, equity, fixed income, and forex market is not really, it's very big, but it's not really something that we look into because forex is a zero-sum game. So if it's one, it's US against Sing, so it's not really an investment. Okay, it's, if you're really gambling in forex, or you do it because you want to do hedging and you need the currency. So the equity returns 1 to 2% annualized on the real return. These for bonds and bills for 1% to 2%. So it's quite low. Sorry, I mean bonds and bills. Okay, because there's no risk, low risk. So for the equity return, its average is about 5%. This return from the last 100 years. Okay, so for the equity, the real return is 5% for the last 100 years. So, but of course, the risk is also higher. Okay, so equity preference share, it actually rank above the common stock for the this payout of dividend. So that's why the word preference is preference share. But preference share usually has a lower return than is equity because they are actually like debt financing. So the only thing is that is the dividend is not tax deductible. Okay, so usually because it consists of fixed dividend, so usually it means that the dividend is lower than equity dividend. So M&A, so of course equity can be public listed or unlisted. So venture capitalist, leverage buyout, management buyout, that is for private equity. So of course, majority we're talking about public equity here. So risk and return of equity securities, so end price minus cost plus dividends divided by cost, and that is the equity securities that we invest in. So reinvest dividend is also a key source of return. Today, $1 invest in 1900 will have grown to 6 purely by price appreciation. But if you reinvest, you can grow by 582 times. Okay. So book value of equity versus market value of equity. Now, book value is what our accounting book is. Of course, it's asset minus debt. And market value is depends on what is traded in the market today. So this is more for public listed company that you have market value of equity in general. Firms return on equity versus investors required return. Management generates accounting return on equity. So return on equity is net income over equity. It means that the equity must be much, you must use this money to generate enough net income, and the ROE must be greater than the cost because you still need to pay your this investor. It can be either investor or bondholder, you still need to pay them. So industry, when we analyze the industry, whether you want to buy the share or not, one of them is Waters, Five Forces. You want to know the industry, how huge is the threat of substitutes product and the bargaining power of the supplier and the consumer. For example, if you are in the F&B, so bargaining power of consumer is quite high unless you are Michelin 3-star, you know, something like that. So substitute is also a problem. So for example, television can be substitute with say computer, or even handphone in futures, you know. So that's probably something that you have to worry about. New entrants, so always there's a new player coming in, and also the current shareholder. So industry life cycle, so this is something that you have to look into, the starting part and the growth, and after that the checkout, then mature, then eventually go to decline. External influence on industry growth, profitability and risk. Government, is a factors. Macroeconomic is also another factor. Demography is also another factor, and technology is also another factor. Approaches to valuation. DCF, discounted cash flow. So we have PB to operating of free cash flow, for example, and price value to free cash flow to present value of free cash flow to equity, one of them. So this is the most popular model for valuation, which is the DCF. And the relative valuation is second popular because it's quite fixed. You have PE, PCF, PB, and enterprise value. And asset base is usually more for plantation, hotel, etc., where they have big asset back. Constant growth dividend discount model. So we have D over R minus G. So that is also part, is like DCF, just that when the company is stable, we have a constant dividend. Asset class and an overview of valuation. So for example, Sprouts Fund paid a dividend last year, reported profit of 0.9. Dividend growth is expected to be 6% for the foreseeable futures, and the investor require a return of 17%. So what you need to do is the dividend 0.9 times the growth 1 plus G divided by R minus G, which is $7.95, which is quite fair, right? 90 cents. And then of course, if you look at from PE perspective, you probably can take back the amount in say 8-9 years. So PE is quite popular, price earning ratios. This is what everybody is looking at. So of course you have trailing PE and leading PE. So you focus more on leading PE, okay, because leading PE is talking about futures and trading PE is talking about the past. So it's but PE, the biggest problem is that you must have E. E means earning. What if you make a loss? But the company cannot be zero cost, right? So PE cannot be applied. PB is more like plantation, where you have property, for example, hotel, etc. Heavy asset type of company. So PS, when you don't have any profit, and then after that you look at price to sales. So because initially your company do not have any profit, so you want to look at PS. Debt security, bonds, fixed income security, and debt security, your local governments, this security, your corporate security, this debt security, but that is quite high risk. You have RESI, you have auto loan, student loan, etc. Basic features of a bond, maturity. So very important, you always look at the maturity, how many years from now, and then after that. So maturity is very important, depends on how many years you need to mature, and then that is where you want to take. For example, you want to take 3 years, you want to take lower risk, 3 years mature, you get the full amount, or you want to wait until 10 years. Or perpetual bond, forever there. So basic feature of bonds is of course the par value, usually is 100, and in Singapore, every single bond is about $250,000 and or $200,000. Coupon structure, it can be a percentage and it can be payout annually or semi-annually. In Singapore, is always half yearly. And coupon rate can be range from 2%, 3%, until even high yield can be 13%, 14% as well. Callable bonds, it means that the bonds that this company can call back. So, you know, that means the company can buy back. Buyback means that the company must give you higher interest rate, because anytime they can just take back the loan, right? The bonds, right? Puttable bonds means anytime you can put back the investor can put back the bonds. So it means that the coupon rate must be lower, because it allows you to put back, right? When the interest rate go up, of course you put it back. Then you can buy a new bonds, right? Which have higher interest rate. Convertible bond depends on the share. So you actually can convert the bonds to the share. And if the share price go up, you just convert everything from your bonds to the share. Fixed income index. So you have Barclay, JP Morgan, FTSE, etc. So primary bond and secondary bonds. So bonds, you must take a look at these bond market. Primary bond is not a lot, and majority are secondary bond. But secondary bond market, because it's not really that transparent, so the spread is always high. So credit risk is very important as well. So you have to know the bonds, whether is there any risk of default. So there's called credit risk. And of course, AAA is the best. Like Singapore government sovereign fund is AAA. And of course, the corporate bonds usually are BBB, etc. So forex is actually a very big market, but it's not for investment. It's more for exchanging, because you need the currency, etc. So if you can see, there is $3.2 trillion per day. So it's actually the biggest market, forex. Okay. So it represents 27% of all trades. Okay. So most popular currency is of course US dollar, and most popular currency pair is US dollar per euro. Okay. And then of course you can go for spot or forward. And that's all for the presentation. Thank you for listening.